Endometriosis is relatively common. The only way to really diagnose endometriosis is to do surgery where you actually take a look inside the abdomen with a laparoscopy and actually visualize the lesions, and you can actually take biopsies to get a tissue diagnosis. With endometriosis, we may, talk about going to the operating room and doing surgery. And typically we do that if the patient has pelvic pain, but there's also some evidence that doing surgery for endometriosis and fulgurating or getting rid of those lesions of endometriosis can actually improve natural fertility as well. So that's one option. And then essentially we can also consider doing ovarian hyperstimulation with intrauterine insemination, and in vitro fertilization is also used for women with endometriosis. Endometriosis is an indication for in vitro fertilization, and the thought is that by doing in vitro fertilization, you can actually remove the oocyte directly from the ovary so that it's not exposed to the inflammatory processes within the pelvic cavity or the abdominal cavity. So I think the biggest thing is to just live a healthy lifestyle, number one. So I tell my patients to, in preparation of in vitro fertilization, make sure that they have a healthy diet, make sure that they're getting exercise. And I think stress reduction is very helpful. There is reason to be hopeful for women with endometriosis and infertility. We have very good outcomes, both with surgical treatment and with doing in vitro fertilization.